Hello, good evening everyone.
Good evening.
Today we are over the sixth part of the lecture, Digestion and Ayurveda part 6. We'll cover the last season, that is Varsha Ritu. Varsha is rainy season. Okay? We are a bit delayed. It starts from 15th July. Okay? So, ek hafta late ho gaya, but that's fine, I think. So, you will also be able to discuss with me ki last 1 week mein kya kya hua, kya kya nahi. So accordingly, we can work out with your complaints. Okay? Now, as we go with our regular protocol, ki isme hamara digestion fire kaisa rehta hai, which dosh gets vitiated, and what we should and what we should not. Okay? So, how's your digestion fire in this season?
Less. Weak.
Weak, correct. So, our digestive fire reduces, our energy in the body reduces. So, that's the reason ki we feel too lazy in this season, right? Jaise summers mein rehta hai, the similar way we feel in this season as well, because we have not got a good digestive fire, we have not got good body power, not good energy. Now the reason behind this is ki vat, which was being accumulated in the summer, it got vitiated or aggravated in this season. That's the reason, you know, we have seen maximum people with joint pain, which aggravating spondylitis, backache, acidity, gas trouble in this season. That's all because vat and Agni Mandya. Agni Mandya is ki your digestive fire is very, very, very weak. So you're not able to digest the food what you're having in a proper manner. That's the reason ki in text it's suggested ki have purana dhanya, that is jitna juna chawal, gehu, jo juna hai, not the new one which is cultivated. Okay, so have the grains which have been stocked for a year and consume those grains. So, then you will be able to digest those. Otherwise, if you have the newly cultivated grains, so it becomes the body to digest it and nourish your body. Okay. So, as I said, abhi vat bada hai. So, from this, and one more thing, ye season mein pitta and kapha bhi vitiated rehta hai. If we just have a look over the complaints, what complaints do we face generally? Besides pain, joint pain, what other issues we have? Cough.
Cold.
Right? So, that is again kapha. That means in this, kapha is not getting aggravated, but the kapha is getting obstructed. We have seen people getting headache. When they look down, it's very heavy for them. Sore throat, tickling sensation in the throat. It is because obstruction of the cough in the pores. How does, and what else complaint do we get? Pain, cough, cold and bloating. Bloating is very common in this season. People just complain of ki acidity ho raha hai, idhar kuch rakha hai, aisa lag raha hai, heaviness of abdomen, though I am eating less, I am eating at regular intervals, but I feel ki I am full. So bloating. So that means ki all the three dosh are disturbed. Vat bad jata hai, kaf obstruct ho jata hai, pitta vitiated ho jata hai. Now as I discussed earlier, ki pitta and fire are correlated to each other, that is our digestive fire. So this again comes ki our digestion becomes weak. Okay. So now as per this, what do's and don'ts should we follow? Agar vat hai, generally hum kya bolte hai, dard hota hai, toh what to do? Apply any oil, apply any balm. The reason behind it is oil is again lubricant, right, which kills the vat. or any balm or anything, oil also if we lukewarm and apply, so it is ushna, it is hot, right? And vat ko kisse dar lagta hai? Oil aur garam chijo se. So isliye I suggest ki once a week, and also because of this rainy season, our cloths are not that well dried up, so we are again prone to fungal infection. So now, as I suggest in winters, ki roj oil lagao, do snehan, abhyang. I can't suggest in this season because we can't take that precaution very well. Abhi footwear gille hai, kisi ka undergarments gilla ho gaya. Now, when we are in the office, we can go home, change and come back. So it becomes very difficult for us to protect ourselves from the fungal infection again. So how do we now lubricate and do something hot to the body for vat? Because see, it can be anyone, even young age people. I won't say only old age people are getting joint pains also. Spondylitis is common at the age of 23-24, right? So again, vat badega, pain badega. In Ayurveda, pain is associated with vat. So they have to do something in rainy season so that they are pain free or with less pain. So what we can go ahead with? Pardon?
Fried food.
Fried food, yeah, right. But again, we won't be able to digest heavy food because we are not having a good digestive. Generally, we prefer chai and bhaji. The reason is, it's not in the text, but this is what I try to make out. In while making tea, we use all the herbs which stimulates our digestive fire, ginger, pudina and all this thing. Huh? And again, pudina pacifies the pitta. And again, we are having bhaji with it. So, you know, we are trying to tighter it, ki chai aur bhajiya khao, ya chai and fried foods. Okay? Now, lubrication, how you can do, if those who are into severe pain, so they can go, ki once a week you apply oil to your body, keep it for 15-20 minutes and have bath with lukewarm water, tap dry your body properly. And then you can use any powder or any herb to prevent the friction or the dryness at the webs and all, because we get those diseases as well. Chikla, Marathi madhe chikla asa kaitari mantan.
Chikla.
Haan. Okay, so we can do this. Now, what else can we do? Which taste would you like to have in this season? Spice. Okay, so we can have spicy food in this season. The reason is again our spices, they stimulate our digestive fire and they also help to provide certain energy to our body. Okay, so that's the reason ki we can have spicy food. But the thing which we should avoid is bitter taste in this season. Okay, because again bitter is tikta rasatmak, which increases vat. So you should avoid bitter things and you should have spicy food and hot food. So that means you have to cook the food and try to have as early as possible. You should not cook and let the food stay over there for long time and then chalo subah ka banaya sham ko khayenge. No. The thing is ki it's not going to be digested, it's not going to be assimilated and it won't be able to provide the proper nourishment to the body. Now, we'll come to our regular dietary products generally which we do have in this season. So, what do we have from your side? Generally, hum barish mein kya kya khate hain? Fried fruit as you said, tell right, fried fruit.
Corn, papad.
All mouth-watering things are coming. And what else do we have? Any special dish from your side ki barish mein hi banana hai? Okay. Tea we will also take. Hum chai isme zyada hi peete.
Maximum.
Tea to ram nahi hai.
हाँ नहीं बट ड्यूरिंग दिस सीजन वो जो रेगुलर नहीं पीता उनको भी ऐसे अर्ज होता है. एनी स्पेसिफिक डाइट फ्रॉम विच फेस्टिवल्स फॉल्स इन दिस सीजन? आषाढ़ी एकादशी है ना आज. हाँ या टुडे इज
आषाढ़ी.
हाँ सो व्हाट डू वी डू जनरली द वारकरीज गो देयर.
हाँ
हाँ करेक्ट. Okay, this is what I wanted. They will be fasting and then how do they?
And the fast is written, varan bhat.
Kare. Haan, dal bhat that is. Kare. Haan. Okay, this is one.
There will not be much of vegetables.
Kare. And secondly, we offer tulsi and we get prasad also with tulsi leaves, right? Which else festival begins in this? Shravan aayega shayad se. Shravan. Shravan. Shravan mein what do we do generally? So now we see ki all this is season of fasting.
It's a fasting month.
Fasting month. Now what was the reason?
At least once a week, say we fast that month. Correct. Particularly.
Haan. Okay. So this is fasting month. But why they are not saying ki pura mahina hi fast karo? Why only once a week? Or why not once in 15 days?
Because the digestion will affect the lining of the stomach.
Correct.
There is no food to digest.
Right.
So, but the food that is given,
that is wrong, which is initially people are taking this day. Earlier, I think so people would be only on fruits during fasting or Rajgira and all as we discussed. Okay, so this is what we are having regularly. In that, fried fruits now comes to bhajia. Generally we go with batata ya kande ka bhajia. So in that kanda ka bhajia is accepted, batata ka bhajia not more because that starch is heavy to digest. Okay, first thing. Corns, yes, we can have because we are not going to have in large quantity. Secondly, we are not having daily. Okay, papad and all these are accessories. The main concept was dal, bhat and tu and fasting. And why tulsi leaves? Because see our immunity is not there at all and secondly we are having obstruction. So tulsi is ushna by nature. I think so I have shared this with you. There was a pregnant lady and being a part of a ritual daily morning she used to take 7 to 8 leaves of tulsi leaves empty stomach. And there were continuous 3 miscarriages in her case. Nobody was able to rule out the cause. Everything was normal. All the blood tests, all the sonography, everything was okay. Then somebody picked it up that she was taking tulsi leaves religiously and that was the reason she had 3 consecutive missed abortion. So tulsi leaf is ushna, right? And secondly, it will help to liquefy the cough as well. Secondly, ushna hai, so again it is going to act on vat. And also stimulate our digestive system. Okay, so that is the reason we offer tulsi leaf and neem bhi I think so chadate hai na. We offer neem as well sir in Ashadi Ekadashi. Neem. Nee, actually he is more aware of this na. Neem as well. But again as I said earlier ki neem to kadwa hai, vaat badhayega. Then why neem? For antifungal, for immunity. Secondly, as I said ki snan ke baad we should use dry powder. So neem ka powder you can use, lodra, vidang. In olden days in school, in the grounds, Ayurveda mein ek churne vidang karke, which is, jaise abhi almendazole dete, deworming ke liye, janta padne saati je aushadha deta. So in old days, in the school ground, along with the sand, vidang, tulsi and neem powder was mixed. And sprinkled over the ground so that kids if they fall they don't have any infection, they don't get worms manifestation from one kid to other. So this was the reason. So you can use this externally or internally as well, but neem not in a major quantity. You can take it once a week also. The reason for fasting is ki if we observe so we get Ashadi Ekadashi and after 15 days I think so Shravan begins. So Ashadi Ekadashi ka ek upas and then it comes Shravan.
Shravan is full upas.
Full upas once a week and many people don't eat in the evening. So nothing to share much. The reason is only that because you're not having good digestive fire and evening you're not working out at all, your digestive system is slugging down. So you have morning and afternoon a light food and evening you be fasting. So what is evening? That is post sunset. So calendar mein to abhi timings bhi diya rehta. We can have a look over that and follow. Okay, anybody has noticed that jis din clouds rehte hai, that day you feel lonely or sad, you start getting pain, depressed. The reason is that there's, as I told you, vat, pitta and kapha. All the three are not in a proper manner. It's obstructed, it's vitiated, it's aggravated. Matlab, agar jaise hum hormonal imbalance bolte, waisa dosh imbalance hai body mein, right? And when there is cloud, what this cloud indicates? Ki heaviness, right? It's going to pour down. Again, wo sun ko dhaak raha hai. Matlab, obstruction, no sunlight, vitiation, depression. So we go into depression. Now in that depressed way, if your soul is not happy, your soul is not active, do you think your digestive system is gonna be active? It will shut down. And usme hum mast achar, papad, bhajiya, dahi, bhat, everything we start having. So what happens? Wo waise abhi, it's a glass of water. Okay? Isko ek din rakha, okay, it's clean water. Next day will it be a clean water? No. Uske upar aur pani dala, to wo acha hone wala hai kya? No. Similarly, aaj raat ko jo maine khaya, it's not getting digested. Again tomorrow morning, I think I'm having everything. I pass the motions as well. But see, it's not being divided. As I always said, the food what we eat is divided into good and bad. In Ayurveda we say sar and kitta. They'll say good and bad. It's not being divided, right? So, hum excretion kar rahe, we are passing stools. But is it bad or only the good thing is going on? That proper that proper digestion is not taking place. So, ideally, if we observe, so many people in Shravan season, they skip one-time meal. Now, again, but the trend has come ki mala sakai office la java lagta. I have to go to the office in the morning, so I can't have a proper meal. So what I'll do, morning I'll fast and evening I'll have my proper meal. Again, that is wrong. One time fasting means preferably evening fasting. Like Jainism, Jain have this Pariyushan in this season. Na? They follow, ki they sit at one place and have everything together and then they will get up. Then they don't have anything besides lukewarm water throughout the day. Usually, but those who are not able to follow it throughout their life, they do this 4 months very seriously. And
normally outside during the rainy season, even people who don't take warm water, they will be taking warm water from the cold water.
Yeah, correct. The reason is that digestive fire is that weak to digest the water as well. So we need to warm the water, it becomes laghu, that is easily digestible and we can consume it to be healthy, clear up the throat, the pores and all. Okay, so once a week fasting and evening fasting, both the thing. Jainism, as you said ma'am, true, ki they eat in the evening, but during this Pariyushan, I don't know what's their festival exactly, they sit at one place, they have whatever they want to while sitting at that one place, and then throughout the day are not going to have anything, only lukewarm water. And some
food is very rich.
That's the problem. It's all ladoos and everything. That's the problem. Again, our digestive fire is not. Nothing. So, wo digestive ke liye jo chahiye wo bhi nahi rehta hai. Okay, no. So fasting can be once a week. So isme kya khana hai, wo nahi will come ki kya kis din nahi khana hai. Once a week or evening fasting, that is one part of the day. But rather than saying it one part of the day, I'll keep it evening fasting only because morning your digestive fire is a bit ignited. Secondly, you're going to work out. So it's getting stimulated and whatever you're having is being digested. If you say ki nahi, subah main upas rakhta hu, shaam ko main pet bhar ke khana kha lunga. I'm going to have heavy food in the night, all that bhaji and all. It's not advisable. Haan, generally, no, this office going.
Some heavy breakfast.
Yeah.
And effect on you become hungry, they advise to take
fruits. Yeah, right. Some of people matlab, who are office going, the young generation, but they want to follow this custom. So they, you know, try to modify it in such a way. Even that Gangor ka upas they do in this way. So what's the reason for, now evening fasting everyone understood, na? Ki digestive fire is weak, so we can skip one meal. Once a week ka, see, many people can't rest. Aisa nahi ki bhook lagta hai, but you know, they have the desire ki time ho gaya to I should have my meal. Otherwise, they go into depression. You don't feel like having a meal. You don't feel like having meal. Or
I feel like having meal. Yeah. You say fasting. Look at the time when like.
Right. So see, this that category of people, it's ki we have to have food. Itna ho gaya na, I should have this 3 to 4 meals per day. If we tell them ki nahi aap mat lo na, again it is going to affect our health adversely. So for them, they came up with an idea ki once a week karo. Okay? So and I as I said, ki fasting never means ki nahi kuch bhi mat khao. And fasting doesn't mean ki have sabudana, have batata, or have all this stuff jo ready-made chivda, farai, chivda and all. And it takes efforts to make all these things. Sabudana vada is not that easy to make. It takes time. Correct. So what we can do, and if you have observed, maximum fruits occur in this season, right? Custard apple, pear, peach, many fruits are available. They are not available round the clock until and unless it's an hybrid one. They are coming up with 12 months ka fruit hai hamara. That cultivation is a different thing, but natural occurring fruits, we get good fruits in this season. Correct. Hamusambi, sweet lime, pear, custard apple, naspati, everything is coming in this. The reason is ki our body is able to digest the fruits. It's not able to digest the heavy starch nor the heavy carbs. But yeah, definitely, since we need instant energy, we need to have some amount of carbs in our diet. Definitely, we won't be able to do a routine activity after a day or two. So once a week, you can be on fruits, liquids. But rather than making juices out of the fruits, you can go ahead with whole fruits because fibers as well is needed. And secondly, when we make juice, na, that micronutrients are crushed. Kisi ne abhi haath pakad ke jo se dabaya, there is going to be some injury over here. Similarly, fruits ko squeeze kiya, to definitely that micronutrients are being crushed. So we are not getting the 100%. So have whole fruits if possible. Ya kisi ko bahut hi problem hai, they can solve it, then it's okay. Okay? So once a week, porridge, yeah. So once a week you can be on fruits, or as I used to say earlier as well, Rajgira. And fruits are, I think, so see, every working lady preparing sabudana and going to office is difficult, rather than, you know, washing the fruits, keeping it in a foil and carrying it to the office. Right? And easy to eat as well. Abhi sabudana vada khane ke liye, you need place. Dabba rakhne ke liye. Fruits kaise, you wash your hands, take the fruits and you can have it as. No, and secondly, I think so, wo taste ka bhi rehta hai na. You can add some amount of salt to the fruits, huh? Upas ka namak, that senda namak which we say, we can add. And in rainy season, one more thing. Fast ka ek ye karan hai. In Ayurveda, there are 5 types of salt. I won't go into deep. Wo kala namak, senda namak, regular salt, all this. We call it samudra lavana. Sendha, this senda namak, is given the priority to be consumed in this season.
Salt.
Sandhav means salt, but sea salt is samudra salt. Again, you know, wo upas ka akha khada white salt. So we should have sandhav, that is sendha namak in Hindi and Marathi. Pantich manta, na sandhav is manta. Rock salt, yeah. So the white one, which is slightly pinkish orange. हाँ हिमालय टी सॉरी
हाँ
ओके तो वी शुड कंज्यूम दिस सॉल्ट इट्स रिटन इन आयुर्वेद देर आर फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ सॉल्ट दैट आई विल टेक लेटर बट इन शॉर्ट कि ये वाला ये सीजन में खाना है तो नाउ पीपल वोंट टेक दिस डायरेक्टली क्योंकि वो नॉर्मल आयोडाइन सॉल्ट का बहुत आदत रहता है तो उपास डाल दो तो लोग ये खाने लगेंगे ऐसा नहीं हो रहा है समथिंग तो गो दिस वे तो पीपल विल स्टार्ट फॉलोइंग तो इट्स नॉट कि वी डू फास्ट और दिस वारकरी इज गो वॉकिंग टू आशा देखो पंडरपुर टू यू नो मेक गॉड वेरी हैप्पी कि नहीं मैं आ गया सी आई टेल यू वन स्टोरी वी ऑल आर गॉड्स किड्स ओके ना एवरी वन इज अ पेरेंट ओवर हियर सी आई टेक मैम्स एग्जाम्पल शी हैज गॉट टू सन एक वाले सन ने मैम के लिए उपास रखा मैम को खुश करने के लिए ए ने बी ने नहीं रखा ही सेड कि नो आई कांट फास्ट तो ही डिडंट डू तो विल यू डू सो मैम कि यू विल गिव मोर प्रायोरिटी मोर लव एंड मोर अफेक्शन टू ए एंड लेस प्रायोरिटी लेस लव एंड लेस अफेक्शन टू बी फॉर यू बट इट वॉज फॉर यू हाँ फॉर हीज हेल्थ राइट बट नॉट फॉर यू यू वोंट कीप दिस इन माइंड कि नो ए हैज डन फॉर मी एंड बी हैज नॉट डन फॉर मी तो ये चेंज है नो ना राइट यू नेवर डिफरेंशिएट एवरी वन विल डू दैट Similarly, I always say this to everyone, any religion it is, we are God's kid. So God is not looking ki nahi aaj ye ma'am ne upas rakha, ye meri favorite hai, ye jo mangegi main isko aaj blessings mein dene wala hu. Sir ne aaj upas nahi rakha hai, he is my notorious child, I am not going to bless him what he wants. Right? We all are God's kid. Any religion I say, to we are equal, jaise Our kids are equal to us. Similarly, we are all equal for the God. There is no variation in it. Right? So fasting more than, I know, Bhagwan ka naam diya because people don't follow it. As I said, ki Ayurveda for skin disease also, they say ki it's your pap karma. The reason was ki if skin is most important to everyone, everyone wants to look beautiful. Now cosmetology is a very fast growing industry in India. Right? So if we say na ghutna kharab hoga ye kharab hoga sometimes hum ha hoga tab dekhenge but skin kharab hoga to isliye add pap karma to skin ki kuch bura kiya to tera skin kharab hone wala so people won't do it and it was earlier also so always for any I'll tell you for fungal infection also in ayurveda they have said ki it's your previous birth ka sin which is coming up सो दैट तुम ये जन्म में ना करो नहीं तो अगले जन्म में फिर यू विल गेट दिस स्किन डिजॉर्डर एनी फंगल इन्फेक्शन सोरियासिस एक्जिमा एनी स्किन डिजीज तो सिमिलरली दिस तो द रीजन फॉर यू नो पुटिंग दिस फास्ट इन टू आर लिटरेचर्स इन टू आर ग्रंथ आयुर्वेद इन टू आर लाइफ स्टाइल एज वेल वॉज टू इट वॉज एज पर अ डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम टू कीप अस हेल्दी सो दैट वी कैन डाइजेस्ट फूड प्रॉपरली एंड नरिशमेंट प्रॉपरली नाउ विल कम टू वरण भात एंड तू So I'll explain you only why to have this, you know, because if I restrict ki nahi ye mat khao aur ye khao, it becomes very difficult our body to accept for anyone. But if it is so ki nahi ye khane se ye kharab hoga, once a while definitely 15 days mein once you can have bhajiyas, no problem. No issue with that. Now why varan bhat hai tu? Varan is of tur ka dal na, I think so. Tur. Bhat and Toop. So see, the reason for adding Toop was, as I said in my first lecture, which was a part one, ki ghee is a lubricant, it stimulates your digestive fire, it's deepan. In Ayurveda, we called it as deepan. It stimulates your digestive fire. And secondly, Toop is like ki haan, ye ma'am mile, inke se achhe se baat karne ka. ये मैम को साबूदाना वड़ा पसंद है तो साबूदाना वड़ा के बारे में बात करने का तो तूप वैसा है मस्का लगाओ टाइप तो इफ इट इज गोइंग विद दाल इट विल कैरी इट्स ओन प्रॉपर्टी अलॉन्ग विद दाल्स प्रॉपर्टी इफ इट इज गोइंग विद चपाती ऑन तो इट्स कैरिंग चपातीज प्रॉपर्टी अलॉन्ग विद ऑल्सो तो इट नेवर लीव्स इट्स प्रॉपर्टी बट इट एनहांसेज इट्स तो तूप इज अ ब्रिलियंट चाइल्ड ओके एंड सेकेंडली तूप हेल्प्स टू इंक्रीज द मज्जा धातु मज्जा इन anatomical terms is your bone marrow. We all get pain right, in this season, including the youngsters. If 20 years ke bhi bolte ki my this is paining, especially the thighs and the calf, they pain a lot. Or sometimes goda hi ne Marathi te pan mantat, that's jam, right? The jammed is because obstruction is there, and again vat is getting obstructed because of calf. So, and secondly, tube helps to enhance your bone marrow. So definitely वहाँ पे खाली जगह. Now if this is totally occupied, there is no space, no stranger will come in. But definitely if there are 2 to 3 chairs vacant, anyone will come in and sit, and we can't deny as well, right? We will react in a different manner, but that would be we won't fight with them, but definitely we'll have a reaction. Place for it, right? Similarly, if our bone marrow is vacant or weak, I would say, so there are spaces. See, the cells should be this way, no space for anyone to enter. But if they are, vata is going to enter, these cells are going to react. Are tu hamare ghar mein kyun aaya? So what they will do? They will cause inflammation, and vata anyways is causing pain. Haan. Full inflammation, wo goda hai ne, to mara mari hota udhar. And then the havoc is created. Now the chairs are so well arranged, everyone is sitting properly. Now if these things happen, somebody comes and there is a mara mari, the chairs won't be lined up, na? Where say drr drr. So similarly, those cells, they are supposed to be like this. They were like this. Vat went inside and they all became scattered. So ghee helps to prevent this scattering, right? It helps to improve your majja diet, it helps to improve your digestive fire, and secondly, it's carrying the quality of varan, which is protein, bhat, which is starch. Kanki te bhat, dal ani tacha varti tuv takta. They never and secondly, they never some people do, but I have observed ki they put bhat, then dal and then tup. They don't take bhat, put tup and then eat dal. They do this because tup carries both the properties then. So wo matlab ekdam enhancer ho jata hai. Got this? So ghee helps to prevent this imbalance in our body of the cells, especially the bone marrow. Okay? What else you like to have in this season? Fruits ho gaya, varan, bhat, tup ho gaya, spicy, then we can add to bhajan. Secondly, it stimulates the digestive fire. Anyone feels like having, sir.
And normally, also in this season, you know that rajgira? That is used more. Rajgira, ladu.
Ladu, chikki. Correct. Jaggery, protein, right. So we give rajgira with gud, and also while making that kind of laddu, we add some ghee to it. Dry fruits or ghee to it. Now dry fruits has to be also in very less quantity.
Shingdani.
Gud. Right. So what we are having all lubricating agents. Again, shingdana is a lubricating thing. But again, this thing should not be having more quantity. You can have one shingdana laddu per day, small. That's okay. But if you feel nahi, 4-5 khalo. And then this season we come across singoda as well.
Water chest,
right? So the reason is ki shingoda, again, it's a good source of calcium. And we all are suffering with pain because vat badh raha hai, vitamin D nahi mil raha hai, to calcium absorption kam ho raha hai, everything. So calcium, have you ever come across shingode ka aata, halwa uska dekha, it's very sticky. Matlab waise chamach se bhi lene jao na, to how sheera, it comes in parts, wo ek se cubes kar sakte, shingoda you can't. It's like a lapsi only, waise pura ek paste aata rehta hai, right? Because it has got that good binding capacity, so it binds our all the joints, shoulder over, koi bhi joints, and secondly it helps to keep the cell binded. I know shingoda is bit heavy to digest as well, so we should have it in less quantity, and once a week shingoda, you get fresh, or you make atta, you get green singoda as a fruit as well. So it has got a very good binding capacity. So that was the reason to administer singoda to upvas diet. So rajgira and singoda was preferred. Now we are coming across sabudana vada. So singoda has got, so it's not allowing that. Again, over here that concepts come. What ghee was doing, now that singoda is also helping us to do. Wo cells ke beech mein space nahi create hone de raha. It's keeping them binded. So again, helps to prevent vat prakop, which indirectly help us to prevent pain. Okay, now related to pitta, we are having ghee. Ghee always helps to pacify pitta. Milk products may avoid curd in this season, because see, any fermented product is, ma'am is laughing.
What? I have curds every day.
See, many people have curds every day, especially those from Mysore and all. They want curd in their diet.
Rice with vegetables.
So
it starts with rice with milk and it ends with rice with curds.
Right.
That's the last thing.
So now we should avoid any fermented food product. The reason is that fermented food products are a bit heavy to digest, and as I said, we should have everything fresh and new. Now fermented food products cannot be fresh in any way. How can we expect them to be fresh? Yeah, ideally we should avoid, but in case, as I said in my earlier lectures as well, somebody who is prone to have curd, and if I withdraw something abruptly, you know, it's being difficult for you, your body as well to accept, because nothing should be withdrawn abruptly. So what you can do, reduce the quantity, have it in afternoon timings only, avoid at night, and after having curd, say after 15-20 minutes, take half teaspoon of gaika ghee or 10 ml of moong ka pani. Either or. So it becomes a bit easy to digest. So we can do this thing. Okay. Now in Jewish culture, they have a festival, I don't know what's that called. They make valachi bhaji. And narli bhat. That is. Coconut ka milk extract karke, how do we use water to cook rice? They use coconut milk to cook rice. Now it wasn't, see, now what has happened, we think that Jews are only from Israel. But the thing is, when they were removed from the Mishra days, so they, you know, spread all over, and they adopted culture over there. So they, and this festival falls in this season only, I think so it was on this Sun, yesterday. Yesterday or day before yesterday, I'm not sure, but this I came through some research work. So what was the reason for this typical diet? As we discussed about Varan Bhata and Tup, we'll discuss about this as well. No? So we'll break down the ingredients. Val, rice and coconut.
Coconut will have the...
Correct. Coconut oil we use to lubricating, and we are taking milk out of it. That means it's proper extract, right? And secondly, it's easy to digest. It's not that heavy to digest, right? Val.
Protein.
Correct. So it's gonna give us nourishment, okay? And rice again, immediate source of energy. Secondly, what happens ki now making roti with coconut milk will be difficult. We can't prepare the dough with coconut milk. So that could be one of the reason to add rice. So this is ideally had on that particular day, but it's suggested ki you should try to have it throughout the month if possible. And again, this diet has to be taken in the afternoon itself. Evening you have to make this, have it, and then evening, I don't know very much, I'm not that sure because I've not gone through the proper literature, but it said ki shaam ko chula nahi jalana chahiye. So again, matlab, हाँ वी शुड नॉट कुक फूड. तो अगेन मतलब शाम को दे आर नॉट हैविंग, दे आर कीपिंग दैट इज वन टाइम फास्ट वॉट वी डिस्कस्ड. सो यू नो एवरी आई सिलेक्ट दिस कल्चर सो इट बिकम्स ईजी फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड. इफ आई से कि ये खा लो तो नोबडी विल रिमेंबर दिस कि कोकोनट वाला राइस एंड ऑल. Now diet is okay. Anything else beside this? From your side also, if there's any input, let me know, because every culture and every tradition has got importance. Because
what role does milk play?
Pardon?
What role does milk play in the seasons?
The regular milk, cow milk, and the see. The thing is, ki we are just keeping in mind ki we need proper nourishment. Okay. Now definitely we are cut, our body is not able to digest the regular meals what we are having. So definitely we have to skip to certain products which are easy to digest and secondly provide nourishment in a proper manner. So that's the reason we go to milk. But second, again milk, it's not necessary to be consumed on a regular basis in this season. Because as I said earlier, we are going to get bloating because of pitta, na? So, and many people have that trouble. And in next topic, I'm going to cover this bloating and all. So, I wish if you are there, I'll explain you in detail. Okay, now our lifestyle. Snehan ka to I said, once a week you can do, or where you have pain and all, at least to lubricate those joints whenever possible. But then you should clean your that particular area, your whole body properly, tap dry it. Just look to that there is no oil, no water between your veggies. This web should be absolutely dry. Especially the feet. You should take too proper care of your feet. And then they have advised you should not wear cotton or cotton socks. Socks were not there those time. But they mean to say, ek to shaam ko bahar jaye na. Or you don't leave your house at the night time, in the evening times, don't go into the dark. The reason is, as we see this day, people are just ruined up into the drainage. Right? So, what time maybe there might be something.
Insects and all.
And they always suggest, ki take a stick and walk. Especially during rainy season. Generally, in Ayurveda, it said, ki you should always have a stick to walk. But especially during rainy season, you should carry a stick. So, you know, you come to know, ki how's the surface? Is it uneven? Because in this season, we are prone to have more of that sprain and all. See, our body is very, I would say, vat, that is very active in this season, right? So, it can just twist off and you can get a cramp very easily.
Support,
because they are very stiff. It takes time to move. In fact, if we ask our hand as well, neen mein se, if you have noticed, it's, in winter, it's very easy to do this, in summer as well. But in rainy season, it's very difficult to change the posture, right? So that's the reason if there's an uneven surface, the mind takes time to adapt, then it sends the message. So you might get a cramp, not a sprain, then a cramp. Ki paon aise jana chahiye tha, aise ho gaya, and you got a cramp over the calf muscles, right? That's one thing. Secondly, avoid strenuous activity in this season. Two reasons: as our body is weak, it's not having that good quantity of power. Secondly, we are not able to provide that good quantity of nourishment as we were able to do in other seasons, shishir, that is autumn and all. So first thing comes in mind is the energy, lack of energy. Secondly, already there is vat prakop, and if you are working out, that means you are sweating, or again space is created, again vat is increasing, so you might get bloating and all. Third, the season. It's not the ideal season to go out to have a walk. How can you? You might slip off, na? If we consider the atmosphere as well.
If we go with an umbrella.
Ha, but then again the. And see, everything, considering dosh as well, vata is going to increase, energy is low, and you're not able to provide that good nourishment as well in this season. I'm not saying ki ye khao, wo khao, as I used to say in autumn, na? I'm saying, nahi, you have only, see, the list was so small, varan bhat tu, nari bhat, and var. And hardly one singnane ka laddu you can have, or something of khopra, shingoda. So we are not giving you a very good diet, ki nahi sab khao, whatever is available, right? And secondly, the surface is uneven.
Vegetables are not good.
vegetables are not, so we are not getting good quantity of microvitamins again, right? Micronutrients are not available to the body. We are lacking in vitamin A, B, everything. Now for non-vegetarians as well, again that you can have fish if it's from a good water or so. But the thing is ki meat, generally it's not advisable, but many people who want to have, they can have because of the fish oil or the omega 3. Okay. And secondly, again, meat and all these things are very heavy to digest. So if you want, and secondly, it's not clean. The environment is not clean. The slaughter place is not that clean in rainy season because it becomes difficult for the shopkeeper as well to maintain the hygiene. So better to avoid, if you, in both the senses, hygiene wise and digestion wise as well. But if you want to, you can go ahead with soups. Okay.
Among the Hindus, that is Maharashtra, those who are omnivorous, you can say, taking non-veg as well as veg during the month of Shravan and even Ashad, they would not take the non-veg.
Non-veg.
And even an egg.
Correct. Very true. From June to August, sometime up to Navratra as well, they carry. And they just correlate it with Abhi Ganpati, Abhi Devi.
Fish.
Breed.
Ideally, it should not, but some people.
The season they are not allowed fishing because they are breeding time.
Breeding time, right. Ideally, it's not allowed, but you know, some people. Acha, during this season.
Sometimes some date in June they give you till September something. It will start on Naril
Purnima.
That is the
date when they start fishing.
Right. So see, even everything is well decided, but then too many people, they want to have. So for those, if they want to I would say ki go with soups if possible. But
there are two reasons for this. One is the breeding this, and the second reason is the sea is stormy.
Yeah, okay. The sea is always stormy.
That Narli Purnima, this sea is settled down because there are no storms.
Correct. So both thing is important. So we should avoid strenuous activities, strenuous exercise, heavy meals to be avoided. Okay. If you want to, generally some amount of mobilization is needed. So besides your daily activity, if you want to do something, go with Shukshma Vyayam. What is Shukshma Vyayam? Yoga or moving small joints, mild aerobic stretching and all. Foot.
Freehand exercises,
free foot exercises you can do, or if somebody has got a very, say, somebody has got ki nahi gyming karna hi hai, to do a short jogging at your place, but not as we do in other season. In other season I say ki by the time you feel sweating you should continue your workout, but not in this and summer. Summer also I think so I denied for it. Okay, any queries? Thank you.
Thank you.